folks, but that's one frustrated Jets team we're talking about right now.
Let's go offside. However, but the shot went into the net after the whistle. That's never appreciated. And now we've got a little pile up along the boards. A frustrated Jets team looking to stir it up. Some tempers flaring.
Rene's agitated. Right,
when you shoot the puck after the whistle, it never goes over very well.
Especially when you shoot the puck into the empty opposition net. Here's the play. That's whistled down. Rinne's quit on it. Scheifele kind of slides it along the floor in behind Rinne, and no, that's just a cultural faux pas. Never, never.
And Ryan Ellis skated right over to Scheifele.
And some pushing and shoving. I remember pulling that stunt once myself and was a little bit surprised at the response I got from the Buffalo Sage team, but slid it into an empty net and I drew a crowd. Not long after that, Rob Ray and I shook the gloves off and exchanged blows for that very reason.
And Mattias Ekholm just pointing at Mark Scheifele towards the scoreboard, and I think he said something like, it's 5-0.
Yeah. Argument's kind of over at
lips,
that point.
He's kind of saying, you know, do what you want, but take a look at the scoreboard.
Or I think as much as anything, you want to try and solve the goaltender while the clock is running, not during static, stationary time.
I'm sure it's a great time for one-liners back and forth in situations like that when things start calming down. And look at the number of players going to the belly box.
Wow.
Everybody coming over to the box.
We've got a sea of bodies in both. I'm counting four players per club, essentially everybody that was on the ice as Scheifele slid that one into the Nashville net. I think a
and now room for more. Possibly.
Referee Wes McCauley essentially says a round of minors for everybody. Treats everybody to a round of minors. I don't recall a moment I've ever seen a penalty box so congested.
Firlamiolet is shaking his head, looking up and saying, boy, let's keep this clock going. Our team has the lead. It all started, the play was offside at the blue line. Mark Scheifele kept going all the way. Everybody had stopped strides ago, and he just put the puck in the net.
And you'll note this, just as the play shuts down, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 Jets players are on the ice.
Because there was a penalty called initially.
And then the sixth Jets skater joins the fracas. I believe the Jets have all six of those skaters we just highlighted.
So there was a delayed penalty as that play was coming in. So that's why the six were there initially. Now, what happened after that is anybody's guess at who came on, who came off. So who's left on the bench is my question. My gosh.
When you stack them up, 5 and 6 in the penalty box, at least for a lot of space on the player's bench. Seven minors are assessed against the Predators and 6 against the Winnipeg Jets. Kelly Yarncroft, Jones can't believe what they're seeing. Plenty of ice time to go around, fellas.
And I believe when it's all said and done, there will be a penalty. There will still be a power play for the Jets, but everybody chuckling because look, Mattias Ekholm doesn't have a seat.
Okay. And that gentleman in the foreground is accustomed to having his own space. That's part of the NHL off-ice crew. He's accustomed to having his own seat. He's going to have to be pressed up right against the glass to accommodate those 2, 4, 6 Predators that have effectively occupied his workspace.
He's going to run out of paper. That's like having too many people on the elevators, too. When, you know, the door opens and the elevator's full, and the guy says, I'll just take the next one. So, look.
That, to me, really is a puzzling. That's a great shot right there, guys. I like the way that one looks. I mean, you look like you've essentially relocated the